Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll understand the trunking theory and how it relates to the capacity of the system. The cellular system relies on the trunking theory for the capacity of the system. It means it allows many users to access the limited number of channels that are available with us. This trunking theory is adopted from the theory used by the landline telephone systems, where there were hundreds of wires and cables laid down for the users. Using the nature of human being to make calls, this trunking theory was adapted. It suggested that a user does not call for 24 hours a day. He calls for a limited amount of time. And hence, the remaining channels that were laid down should be used for other users. In this way, using the limited amount of channels, we are able to accommodate many more users in the system. The fundamentals of trunking theory were developed by a mathematician called as Erlang. And hence, the unit of trunking is given in terms of Erlangs. Hence, the measurement of traffic intensity is given in terms of Erlangs as a unit. One Erlang represents the traffic carried by one channel. It means one call that is on for an hour on one channel or one call that is on for an hour per minute. Now we will move on to the next definition called as grade of service. Grade of service means the ability that the user is able to access the channel in the busiest hour. If we say that the grade of service is 2%, that means for every 100 calls, 2 calls will be blocked because the channels are not available. For us, it is important that the grade of service should be such that all the channels should be available for any user to initiate a call. We now move on to the next definitions. These definitions help us understand what are the various terms in the entire trunking theory. The first definition is setup time. Setup time means the time required to allocate a trunking channel to the user. This is the time in which the user will initiate a call and will wait until the channel has been allocated for him to begin his conversation. The next definition is blocked call. This is a call which cannot be completed due to unavailability of the channel. It is also called as lost call. Blocked calls appear because there is a congestion in the system and all the channels are already been used by other users. Hence, there is no more channel available for the user to begin the conversation. The next definition is holding time. This is the average duration of a typical call. It is denoted by H. Next definition is traffic intensity. This is the most important definition because it helps us understand that what is the intensity of the traffic or how much of the channel has been occupied by other users, and hence helps us understand the grade of service that a system provides. Traffic intensity is a measure of channel time utilization, which is the average channel occupancy measured in Erlangs. This is a dimensionless quantity and may be used to measure the time utilization of single or multiple channels denoted by A. The next definition is load. It is the total traffic intensity which is measured throughout the trunking system and it is measured in Erlangs. Next definition, grade of service. Grade of service is a measure of congestion that is specified by the probability of a call being blocked for Erlang B or the probability of a call being delayed for Erlang C, and it is denoted by A. Next definition, request rate. The average number of call requests in per unit time is called as request rate. This means how many calls have been made in per unit time duration. Now we will move on to the traffic intensity and its calculations. The traffic intensity offered by each user is equal to the call request rate multiplied by the holding time, which is given as AU, which stands for the intensity of a single user, which is equal to lambda into H. Lambda is a call request rate, that is made per unit time, and H is the holding time duration of the call. Similarly, we can calculate the total traffic that has been offered, which is given as capital A is equal to U into AU, where U stands for the number of users that are using the system. The traffic intensity per channel is given as AC, which stands for the intensity per channel, is equal to the total intensity divided by the channel, which is equal to U into AU divided by C, where C is the number of channels in the system. There are two types of trunk system that we'll be learning. The first trunk system is called as block calls cleared. The second trunk system is called as block call delays. In the first system, that is block calls cleared, if the user is trying to access the system and the channel is free, he is immediately given the channel to talk. If the entire system is busy and there are no more channels available for the user to initiate a call, then in this case, the call is getting directly blocked, and hence it is called as block calls cleared. The user is then free to access the system the next time. The second type of system, which is called as block calls delayed. In this system, when the user tries to initiate a call, if there are no channels available in the system for the user, then he is put into a queue. In that queue, he is waiting till the channel is available for the user. If the channel is not available for a specific duration, then the call will get dropped. Hence, the system is known as block calls delayed, where the call gets delayed for a certain amount of time till the channel becomes free in the system. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.